Brobee. Do you want to go to Africa?
Yeah.
We quickly headed to the airport and left for Cape Town, South Africa. The waters looked beautiful from our view from the plane. Once we landed, we took squiz cabs to the Castle of Good Hope. This castle once was a 17th century star fort and is now declared a historical monument. We stopped to look at an art exhibit while there. Next, we headed over to Camps Bay. The beach was very crowded due to the summer weather attracting many tourists. To get a good view, we took an aerial cable ride up Table Mountain. At the end of the day, we went up Lion's Head Mountain to overlook the city at sunset. It was gorgeous. Our next destination was the Kalahari Desert. We stayed at the Kalahari Transfrontier Park, which provided us a nice lodge to stay at. The Kemsbok, a type of antelope, resides here. The Kalahari Desert is the sixth largest desert in the world. We next headed off to Chobe National Park. We were very excited to go on our very first African safari. Did you know that hippos can consume up to 150 pounds of food per day? Or how about that elephants have memory spans that last many years? The 9 subspecies of giraffes can be distinguished by the patterns on their coats. Zebra stripes are so unique that they are like fingerprints. No two are exactly alike. The leopard's ears can hear 5 times more sound than an average human ear. Vultures use their beaks more often than talons when attacking their prey. Victoria Falls was our next destination. These falls flow into the Zambezi River. While there, we visited Devil's Pool overlooking the falls and went bungee jumping over the Zambezi River. We next headed to Kabale Forest National Park. The park was filled with all types of wildlife. In the park lives many endangered chimpanzee species, such as the red colobus. There are over 229 species of trees living in the park. While there, it was really hard to miss the birds. There are 325 sighted species of birds at the park. We next headed over to the more urban part of Africa, Nairobi, Kenya. On the outside, Nairobi appears to be a pretty wealthy city, but nearly 4 million people are living under brutal poverty, contributing to the 46% of Kenyans living below the poverty line. For some weird reason, Nairobi wanted to visit Mogadishu, Somalia. Tourists are advised to never travel alone. Due to low law enforcement, bombings and shootings are very frequent. Under extreme protection, we visited the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. The monument was made in honor of the Somali men and women who died protecting the Somali Republic. We swiftly left and headed off to our final destination, Timbuktu, Mali. These buildings are a great example of the Western African Islamic style. The Djingerber Mosque is a famous learning center of Mali. Brobee and I had a fascinating time on our trip to Africa.
Even outside.